The Apple Watch is a great smartwatch, but it's kind of expensive, starting at $400 US for the Series 6 and $280 for the Apple Watch SE. So I wanted to find you the best cheaper alternatives. The good news is there are plenty of options to choose from if you're not quite ready to spend as much as the Apple Watch. You have options from Fitbit, Samsung has some alternatives, Garmin has some great ones, and even Apple themselves have the Apple Watch Series 3, which is around $200, and you can find it usually a little bit cheaper when it goes on sale. But look, even that is way too much money for me. So I wanted to go really cheap, and I found you the three best alternatives under $100. Starting from least expensive to most expensive, we have the Letsfit Smartwatch, then we have the Ndur Smartwatch, and finally the Amazfit Bip S. But the best thing about all these three is that unlike the regular Apple Watch, they work with Android and iOS. So let's get started. Starting with the cheapest cab off the rank, we have the Letsfit Smartwatch. Now, all of these watches look pretty similar to one another on the outside. They all have a square watch face, just like the Apple Watch, and a single button that you use to control the interface. And they're all touch screens, of course, and they're all color. The Letsfit one is 1.3 inches. And I have to say, it's actually a pretty nice looking screen. I was looking at it and going, I didn't think that this watch was worth $35. It definitely looked a lot more expensive than 35 buckaroos. Now, what you need to know is all these watches work in a pretty similar way in order to navigate the watch themselves. So you can usually swipe down to see notifications, swipe up to see things like your daily steps and statistics like calorie burn, for example, and then swipe left and right to access some quick settings or the menu options. Now, if you want to change the look and feel of the watch, usually a smartwatch has several different watch faces to cycle through. The Letsfit only has four, which is fine. They're all pretty functional. You can't really change any settings on them at all. It's just pretty much the presets that you're stuck with. There is a kind of cute reindeer smartwatch face, even though I think that's only really gonna be valid for about 2 months of the year. So let's talk exercise tracking. The Letsfit tracks 8 different exercise types, including walk, run, bike, climbing, yoga, treadmill, hiking, and the spin bike. In terms of overall calorie burn, this gives you an idea of your calorie burn throughout the day. Of course, your step tracking as well. And you'll also be able to track your sleep with it. Now, the sleep tracking was actually fairly accurate. It got the duration pretty much spot on. This watch, like many other watches in this price range, only has connected GPS. Now, this means that you need to take your phone with you if you want to calculate distances, see a map of your route, and all of that good stuff. You can't take it out independently without your phone. And if you're looking for a moment of zen in your day, then similar to the Apple Watch, this watch will give you some breathing exercises that you can do, buzzing to tell you to inhale or exhale, and make you nice and relaxed. Doesn't work for me, but it probably will for you. I'm just a weirdo. As for the other smartwatch features, if you're not interested in the exercise and fitness stuff, don't worry. This is a watch that gives you a lot of extra features when it comes to getting notifications from your phone, for example. I found that all of the major apps were supported. You can also be really granular in toggling on and off which ones you want to come through. That said, you will not be able to respond to notifications on this particular watch or any of the others that I'm talking about in this video if you are on iOS, and that's just a limitation of pairing any watch that's not an Apple Watch with the iPhone. But you can see calls and things come through and then respond accordingly on your phone. Battery life on this watch is excellent. It's actually going to give you around 10 days of full use and 30 to 40 days if you really, really push it and put it in standby mode and basically don't use it, but then I don't know why you have a watch in the first place. But that's pretty standard amongst the other watches that I'm talking about in this video. The battery life is great compared to the regular Apple Watch. You know, all the variants of the Apple Watch, the most you can get out of them is pretty much 2 days once you turn off all the bells and whistles, like you're always on display. So, you know, for not too much cash, you get a lot of battery life. I really like that. Next up, let's talk about this smartwatch. This is the Ndur Smartwatch, N-D-U-R. Okay, cool, huh? I actually really like the build quality and the design on this one. It feels a lot more premium than the other options, which are a little bit more plasticky overall. The bezel is really nice. I like the selection of color options as well that you can get. And the strap was actually, I think, the most comfortable out of all of the watches that I tested. So I really enjoyed that. The touchscreen itself is 1.4 inches and it's a color screen. And I do have to say that the brightness of the screen when I was doing an outdoor workout was actually the brightest out of all of them when I set it to maximum. All right, let's talk exercise tracking. Now, this watch does 7 different types: walking, running, cycling, skipping, badminton, basketball, and football. I don't know who tracks badminton, but hey, it's there for all your badminton fans out there. Now, again, connected GPS, so it means you have to take your phone with you to actually track your distance and your route and all of that stuff. Now, unfortunately, I worked this out the hard way. If you want to track and say, look back at a map of your route or your run or your walk, whatever have you outdoors, you actually need to go into not the watch itself. You need to start the workout tracking from the phone app, which was a little bit, you know, counterintuitive. I'm so used to starting all of my workouts from the watch itself. One other challenge that I found was that there is no way to track a stationary workout. And by that, I mean something that doesn't involve distances. Say, for example, like if you're doing a weights session or doing something like yoga. Now, I did ask Ndur and they said that the best way to track something like that was to just not track it at all, just do the workout and in the background, your heart rate and calorie count will be reflected in your overall totals. So unless I wanted to go in and, you know, do the math and just like subtract from my total and the amount that I had before I started the workout, yeah, it was a little bit annoying, but you know, you're paying $65 for a smartwatch, so I can't ask for that much, but I kind of want to. Now, this watch also shares something with the Apple Watch that none of the other two do, and that is a blood oxygen or SpO2 sensor to give you a spot reading. Now, this isn't a medically cleared sensor. It is not FDA cleared or anything like that. So do not, please do not go use this to diagnose anything. And there is also a blood pressure monitor as well that takes a reading on demand. Now, unfortunately, I didn't have either a pulse oximeter or a blood pressure cuff to test out the accuracy of this. So please do take any readings it gives you with a grain of salt. Now, the sleep tracking on this watch was not particularly accurate. It said I was in my light sleep zone when I was doing the dishes and sitting on the couch watching television. Now, let me tell you, if somehow magically I could invent something that did the dishes while I was asleep, I would pay a lot more than $65 for that, let me tell you. But if you're looking for the most accurate sleep tracker, I don't think it's gonna be this one. As for the smartwatch features on board, look, again, notifications are fairly standard and battery life is excellent at 7 days. And the other cool thing on board is the ability to use the watch as a remote shutter for the iPhone or whatever phone you have it tied to. I really like that. It's actually kind of similar to what the Apple Watch offers when you have it with an iPhone. So to be able to get that on such an inexpensive smartwatch was kind of neat. And finally, the $70 Amazfit Bip S. Now, this watch, again, square watch face, looks very similar to all the others on the list. I would say that this one feels, I think, the most cheap out of all of them, even though it is the most expensive. But don't let that deter you because it's actually really comfortable on the wrist. And I didn't find there to be any issue with this when I was, you know, doing a sweaty workout, sleeping with it or taking a shower and just being lazy and not wanting to take it off. So I think it was probably the lightest and the most comfortable out of all of the three. Now this one has a 1.3 inch color TFT display. It's also a touchscreen, but the resolution and just the overall look just doesn't look as nice as the other two watches in this comparison. That said, the battery life is really good and we'll talk about that later. And also the other advantage that this watch has is that it has an always on display, so you don't always have to keep raising your wrist to see the time in a similar way to the Apple Watch also has an always on display. Unfortunately, there is also a backlight, so you don't have to always rely on that kind of grainy TFT display. When you raise to wake, the watch should illuminate most of the time. It can track everything from run, cycle, elliptical, treadmill, walking, spin, weights, yoga, pool, and outdoor swimming. Now, the important thing to note is this is the only watch out of the other two that I've mentioned that will be able to track your swims. So if that's important, don't look at the others, just get this particular watch. Another key advantage with this watch is that there is a GPS built in. So this means you don't have to take your phone with you if you want to go out on a walk or a run and see your distance, your splits, your map, and all of that stuff. Now, the one thing I will say about the heart rate measurement on the Amazfit Bip S, the watch face itself, that one that actually has the heart rate monitor on it for resting heart rate, you know, it doesn't update very quickly, and a lot of the time you're either left with like two dashes of lines and so you're like, am I dead? Or it's just something completely wrong. So, you know, if you actually want to check your resting heart rate, go into the heart rate option and check it that way. Now, the Bip S was also the easiest watch face to see when I was doing a workout. All of the metrics that I wanted were on the screen, really easy to see. The others were not organized as well, and I couldn't customize what options I saw. And the app itself, compared to the others, which, let's be honest, they're a little bit janky, it's actually the most robust overall of all the apps. It just gives you a lot more control and a lot of granular options. Sleep tracking, again, not super accurate on this watch. I have to say the Letsfit was probably the most accurate out of all of them. It said that I was awake when I was, you know, my alarm went off at 5 a.m. to pre-order an iPhone, because that's what I do. And it said I was slept through the whole thing. So I'm good at pre-ordering phones, but not that good. Now, this watch gives you the most overall battery life, around 15 days when you are just using it normally, getting notifications and all of that stuff and tracking workouts, but up to 40 days overall. Now, the Bip S also has the widest selection of watch faces to choose from. There are around 40, and you can also customize a couple of them too. So for me, it gives me the most close experience to an Apple Watch in that regard, even though the actual screen itself doesn't look as pretty. So now you've seen what each of these watches can do, time for you to choose the one that is the most appropriate for your needs. Now, for me, I think I'm gonna choose the Amazfit Bip S. Yeah, the screen doesn't look as good. And yes, like, there are some quirks with it, absolutely. But the battery life and the versatility in the workout tracking that it gives me was just better than the other two. But I love the look and feel of the screens of these. The Ndur looks and feels beautiful and way more expensive than it actually is. And the Letsfit was just a great do-it-all companion if you're looking for the most bare bones option without sacrificing too much at all. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this comparison was super helpful for you in working out which cheap alternative is the right one for you. Make sure, if you want to find out more comparisons about other great smartwatches and other amazing tech products, you can just click those videos over there. See ya!